I never really think that I was going to be in this position where I'm actually vying for a medal, and I'm actually, realistically speaking, that I actually can. And I didn't really think of this, and you know, my coach was saying to me maybe a week ago, he's like, sorry for the language, no bullshit, EJ, you need to stay focused, we have a chance to do something special here, do what you need to do, don't be, you know, idiotic and do something, you know,
stupid,
exactly. Yeah, yeah, sorry for the language.
yes, we understand. Wow.
EJ, gaano kalaki yung naging contribution ni coach sa ano mo, development mo as a pole vaulter. Coach
You cannot tell my story without telling Vitaly. You know, he basically started back in 2014. And you know, he's the guy who made me jump what I'm jumping now. And he's the guy who's been with me the most through it all. You know, when I was injured, when I turned my ACL, he was not physically there. He was calling me, it's like really devastated as well. And you know, I believe I wouldn't be where I'm at without Vitaly. He's produced so much great pole vaulters, and I'm just happy that he saw something in me, and he decided, you know, I want to make this guy jump a little bit higher, a little bit better, and I'm just happy.
Almost a century, almost 80 years, 90 years since Simeon Toribio won a medal in athletics. A Filipino winning a medal in the Olympics hasn't happened in like 80 plus years. And now, do you see the significance of that? Do you feel the...
You're telling me I didn't know the stats, so I'm getting goosebumps. So, you know, I'm just here to do my part, is to jump, and I know what I'm able to do. I've competed with these guys multiple times, so I just need to bring my normal self come that qualification day, and hopefully the finals.
You grew up in athletics, your father is athlete. And did you dream about this being in the Olympics and winning a medal?
Taking part, definitely. You know, that was definitely a dream that I didn't know if I could achieve or not. I have training today actually. I need to do some training. I might do it here inside the hotel because I can't really have access yet to the training venue, so I need to do it here. And tomorrow I believe I would have rest, and then Sunday I need to do some warm-up, and then I think Monday would be my last jump session, then a various of trainings afterwards, which my coach is planning for me.
Kailan yung ano mo, pasok sa bidding?
Hindi ko pa po alam. I'm waiting with Sir Terry and Patakas and POC and, you know, the governing body's decision on how that's gonna be.
Kasama mo yung si coach mo dito?
Hindi po. Yung coach ko po na sa team with Brazil po. But he's gonna be there in the competition. He's gonna be here, I believe, by Sunday. So, yeah, hopefully everything goes well.
What do you think about your chances here in Tokyo?
I mean, I have a shot. So, you know, I mean, that's all I've asked for. And I know what I can do. I'm excited. In a way that I can control, so which is good.
Is nag-resolve na yung issue nung pagdating sa equipment?
Opo, buti nga po. Actually, umaga ng umaga lang po yung na-resolve nung, I think, mga 9 in the morning. So, flight ko 5-9 lang po na-confirm yung post na it would be loaded sa plane. So, you can imagine the stress the day before.
Oo nga. We were talking to Terry Katista, and he was saying, You were under some stress during that time.
I mean, I'm a pole vaulter, you know, so that's my job, to jump with the pole. So if I come here in Tokyo without my pole, then I can't do my quote-unquote job. So, yeah, that was stressing me out a bit. The new poles actually shipped in Italy late July, and they arrived there damaged. So it's the same issue that I'm worried here because I haven't seen the post. Should be arriving today, which Sir Terry actually organized to just make sure that it arrives today. So, you know, it's a bit of a... It's not that I feel comfortable with my post or something special with it. It's the same post. I'm just sure that this one is working fine. You know, it's not damaged. Hopefully not from the air trip. So that's basically why I wanted to bring my own set. You know, it's not that mas gusto ko to, gamay ko ganun. Wala for me, hindi ako masyadong apektado doon. Ano is sigurado ko 'yun. Ako 'yung naging pake, alam ko kung paano ko inimpake. Alam ko kung saan 'yung may tama man 'yun. Mamaya bubuksan ko, makikita ko kung hopefully, fingers crossed, walang damage yung pool. So,
okay naman lahat.
Hindi ko pa po nabubuksan kasi dahil sa quarantine dun sa protocols po nila, hindi ko pwede buksan yung bag during the airport. So, dun na daw po sa venue na po. Kasi nakapack po yung buong bag ko. So far, visually, I can guarantee wala pong damage. Pero of course, you cannot see but on the inside, so hopefully we'll be okay.
But at least medyo na ease na yung
anxiety
mo na
nandito po yung pole.
How many poles do you usually bring to a competition?
Normally, I travel with 8.